Hey, everybody, and welcome back. So they say if you want to have a successful YouTube channel, you must post videos every day. What happens when you don't like the market and you don't want to trade? And it kind of reminds me of that song by Kenny Rogers. Now, I'm not going to scare you away with my rendition of this song, but you got to know when to hold them, you got to know when to fold them, you got to know when to walk away, and you got to know when to run. And this is one of those situations where you got to know when not to be in the game. So why am I not too interested in trading the markets right now? Well, there's a couple of reasons. First of all, the fundamental data is pretty good. If we take a look at the data that has come out lately, a lot of the data, with the exception of today, is very, very favorable for the US dollar. And not for the US dollar, for the US economy, right? And even last month, a lot of the data was pretty favorable, so I'm expecting the market to remain pretty strong. Now, today we had some really interesting data that came out. We had CPI come out today at 0.4%. Now, this is quite a jump versus the expectation, not very much. But in light of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, really the last 7 reporting periods, inflation is back on the table. And you can see it's almost at levels. It's almost close to the highest level it's been since really 2013-ish, with the exception of right here. So this, to me, is going to be extremely hawkish for the Fed. So with the exception of this data and also the unemployment claims data that showed a big spike in unemployment claims, not just because of the hurricane, but also the month or the week before, September 7th, September 7th, that could have been related to the hurricane, but it's this number right here that's giving me a lot of attention. And basically, I'm thinking that the Fed could raise rates faster than a lot of people think they're going to raise rates. Now, there's almost a 0% chance. The Fed futures are almost pricing in a 0% chance of a rate hike in 5 days from now. Almost zero, right? 98.6% chance that we're going to get a rate hike in 5 days from now. Now, I kind of disagree with that a little bit, and even November, they're talking about only a 3% chance, 4% chance of getting a rate hike in November. Now, I completely disagree with this number, because I think the data, and I think the Fed, the data that the Fed looks at, which most people really don't follow the data that the Fed looks at, I think it's going to be very, very positive, and I think that we are going to see another rate hike this year, right? And is it going to be December? Let's see what the futures are pricing in. Yes, they're pricing in a 50% chance by December. So everybody thinks it's going to be December. However, I think on September 20th that it's going to be a lot more hawkish than people are expecting, because the data is pretty strong. And the hurricanes didn't do nearly as much damage. Forgive me if you live in Houston, if you hear this. The hurricanes didn't do as much damage as expected. I'm sure they did terrible damage. I don't want to take away from that. If we put that together with North Korea still blabbering their mouth, we know they have a hydrogen bomb right now, And they're just, today they came out and said they're going to wipe their enemies off the face of the earth. They're pissed off as can be about the new sanctions that got through the UN. And, you know, they're talking it up a storm. And if we combine that with high PE multiples in 2017 that are off the charts, 50% drop, 50% drop. I do not want to touch this market. There's too much conflicting information right now. Fundamentals are saying higher, but there's so much that can happen here that it's just too much for me to be aggressively buying as much as I normally would like to be in this situation. So I'm kind of sitting tight because I don't think there's a lot of room to the upside. I think the room to the upside, we could see 255. It is possible. But I just believe that with the high price earnings multiples, with the North Korea threat that is very real, people say, well, they're not going to do anything. No, they might not do anything. But I want to warn you guys about something. Do you know how antiquated Russian nuclear technology is? If I can find something here. Russian nuclear technology and false signals. See if I can find something here. There are many instances, World War III by mistake. That's what I'm concerned about. Probably can't find it right now, but there were some stories that I was reading about the fact that the technology that is in these Russian nuclear war launch systems is like 1980s still, right? And they're really, really antiquated. And what scares the heck out of me isn't necessarily a threat from North Korea directly. It's more a threat from an accidental mistake. There was an instance just a short while ago where there was a falling star that was coming out of the sky. We were having a meteor storm, and the Russians almost launched full ballistic nuclear attack because they thought they were under attack. It was a falling star. You go Google the story if you want to find it. So what scares me the most about this situation is not necessarily, do I think North Korea can do something? Yeah, I think they're going to launch a few more missiles over Japan, maybe, you know, do a couple of more things, but I don't really think that's going to be a real serious threat for multiple reasons. I made a video on my website, you know where it is, where I talked about North Korea. You can go to my YouTube channel, and I talked about how North Korea isn't really that big of a threat. But what does scare me is the potential for an accidental World War III. So, that being said, I wanted to explain to you guys, I had a trade that I placed earlier this month where I did a back ratio credit spread, which basically, if the market went higher, I'd make a small amount of money, but if the market had a big correction, I would make a tremendous amount of money. And I only lost money if the market was in here. Let me just show you quickly. I only lost money if the market closed in here. 242. It looked like that. So I made money if it went higher from here, and I've already cashed in on that trade, and I made a lot of money if it went lower, and I lost money if the market closed in here. It was a put ratio back spread, and I'm actually cashed out of that with some nice profits already. So right now, I really don't know what to do as far as a longer-term trade goes. As far as day trading goes, it's pretty much business as usual, but I'm trying to get away from day trading these days for personal reasons. I'm actually going to be taking a job very soon at a very large Canadian conglomerate and managing millions of dollars for them. So I'm kind of shutting down my personal day trading and focusing more on longer term trades just to get in the habit when I take that job starting October 1st. So there you have it. I've made my video for the day, and hopefully you guys will take a little bit away from this. And remember, don't be surprised if we get another launch from Korea, and it would happen after the market's closed. And, you know, the futures will drop like a stone, like they always have. Will they buy it? They should buy it again, but, you know, who knows? Right now, it's a little bit too risky for me. Valuations are too high. You got to know when to hold them. You got to know when to fold them. You got to know when to walk away and know when to run. So as far as day trading is concerned, keep going. Things as normal. As far as swing trading is concerned, you got to design trades that fit market conditions. And that's the trade I had when we were down here. I did a put ratio backspread with a credit. I pretty much took off the trade with the credit. Small credit, tiny profit, not a big deal. And that's it. Bye for now.